Hey everyone, I'm working here on some scanner amps, and as I've been tending to do lately here, and I noticed something, and it became a great point and a great time to show something that I've been talking about for a while, and it's mentioned in my Projector Connections article, and it's the concept of ground loops and how they can manifest themselves in the visual. So let's just talk about and show what we've got going on here. What we've got is kind of a typical scenario of two separate scanner amps driving two separate scanners. Now, in some cases, you have a single scanner amp driving two scanners, and in this case, and in many cases, we have a scanner amp per scanner. So we have two separate scanner amps and two separate scanners fed from the same power supply. Now, one of the things I mentioned in my Projector Connections article is you got these signals coming in. You got the plus signal and the minus signal. But you also have this third signal, which is a ground, and what do you do with that? Well, the kind of commonplace, the thing you would think to do with it, the intuitive thing is to kind of connect these together and then further connect them even to the input signal, but you definitely should not do this, especially if you have two separate scanner amps, and here's why. We'll show you a real life example over here in this grid. I'm projecting a grid pattern. And as you see, it looks pretty good all over. And the two grounds are not connected to anything right now. And in a second, what I'm going to do is I'll connect these two grounds together. And they're connected together right now. And what you see happen is all of a sudden, you get some overshoots here on the top. You got some overshoots here on the left-hand side as well. And actually, what I'll do here is I'll make it connected, disconnected, connected, disconnected, and you'll see this image kind of change as I'm doing that. So now this disconnected looks good, connected looks bad, disconnected good, connected looks bad. So not only do we have these overshoots, but all the lines kind of become bendy as well. I'll show you a different test pattern. Laser media test pattern, we'll kind of head straight on there, and they're disconnected now, and when I connect them, what you'll see is this center feature, instead of the lines being straight, they all of a sudden become bendy. So this is what happens, and this is why in my Projector Connections article, I recommend that you not connect these things really to anything. And so, come back here, Eric. So here's what's happening. You got a single power supply connected to both scanner amps. When one scanner amp needs to accelerate on X, that will draw a lot of current from the power supply, and it draws that current through the ground connection. You've only got one ground connection here, right? And so as long as these two scanner amps can maintain a separation, when this draws a lot of current on the X-axis, through its own ground, it won't really communicate to the y-axis. But when you connect these two ground connections together, like this, what will happen is that now, when the x-axis draws current, it actually communicates that current pulse through the y-axis, and so you have a situation where the x will be communicating or cross-talking to the y, and Y will be cross-talking to the X during times of hard acceleration on Y. So let me show you another cure to that other people recommend. Just one second. We'll come back here to the grid test pattern, and now these two grounds are connected, and what we see is we definitely have these overshoots all over, and things are bent and so forth. So let me show you the other way to solve this, and this is the way that other scanner manufacturers tell you and recommend to solve. What they tell you to do is to take a really thick piece of wire, like I've got a copper braid here, and connect the two scanner amps together with as short and thick of a copper connection as you can get, thereby not allowing the two scanner amps to go very far from each other during these times of heavy current pulses. So if you turn back towards the grid, you'll notice I do have the copper braid in place now, and it's really helped a lot, but it hasn't really completely eliminated that problem. What I'll do is disconnect the copper braid, Go ahead and stay on the grid here. We'll disconnect the copper braid, and you see it's pretty bad and very obvious. I connect the copper braid, and it's really a lot better, but it's still not 100% solved there. We still got a little bit of overshoot there, and so the real cure is just to disconnect these two ground connections at the input, thereby restoring a perfect grid. Now, all of this is discussed in my projector connections article on how to make these grounds and how to make sure that you don't get any of these phantom ground loops. And so if you see anything like this in your images and you suspect that maybe one thing is communicating to another through the grounds, you should check out the projector connections article and just make sure that the connections that are made exactly the way I say in the projector connections article. And what that will help you to do is maintain these crisp, clean, beautiful images. So thanks, and we'll see you in the next video.